Hey guys, it's Roy Kerberos, and welcome back to my FIFA 16 Liverpool career mode, where last time off we started the January transfer window. We're playing matches against MK Dons in the FA Cup, and against Everton in the league. Now, the first match this episode should have been against Leicester, but I forgot to hit record and played the match willy-nilly. So you missed the debut, the official debut of my new player. Yes, I have signed someone, and Daniel Sturridge has been sold. But who? He was actually not a part of the deal. Well, I signed someone, one of the players who didn't include Daniel Sturridge in the deal. And Sturridge was actually sold by the board to Bayer Leverkusen. So, who did I sign? Well, if you saw the last episode, you know it can only be one of two players. It's either Neymar or Cristiano Ronaldo. As City did not accept my offer for Sergio Aguero. Oh, they asked for a bit more money than I was willing to offer. So, who did I go with? Did I go with CR7? Or did I unite Brazil? Those two most promising great talents. The answer is... it's Neymar! It was a tough decision, but I went with Neymar. As you can see, he's going to be playing striker. Initially, I was planning to play Royce at striker because he used to be able to play at striker, but he doesn't play at striker anymore. It's just left mid and cam now. Because, fuck the fact that he used to be a striker. So, Neymar is my new striker with Correa, and Coutinho is partnering up with his Brazilian brother from another mother. Let's get in and kick West Brom's ass. And just so you don't feel left out, he scored a hat-trick. So, he's on good form. So, I'm actually... two back-to-back 5-0 wins. So it's not a good day to play me if you're West Brom Italian. Especially at home. And this is Neymar's home debut. Who knows, so. And as I previously stated, Daniel Sturridge is no longer with the club. But as you see, West Brom are saying nicely at night. They could... they probably won't be in ninth at the end of this match, unfortunately, for them. As you can see, the game gave Neymar number 9. I have no problem with that. I would have given him number 11, but Bale has it. Leave it in the comment section below. Should I switch? Give Bale 9 and give Neymar 11? Or should I stick with 9 and 11 for the, as they are? And also, let me know, would you have chosen Neymar over Ronaldo? Though, I mean, in the long term, it is a much better move. I mean, Ronaldo is older than Neymar. Neymar is still only 24 in the game. So he has a few more years left. Well, I could get about 10 years out of Neymar. And there's confirmation that he did score a hat-trick against, against Leicester. Looking good in his new jersey. I bet that would freak out a lot of people seeing Neymar just casually... he wearing a Liverpool jersey. Useful block in those circumstances. I mean, he might do who for fun. And in his spare time, he's good friends with Coutinho. And his buddy Suarez used to play for us. So. And Mascherano used to play for us too. All connections between us and Barcelona, isn't there? To think they'd sell us some of the young players is when we're packing the talent or just calling up whoever is good for my youth academy. Anyway, it's good that Ney was here. Should be fun times with him and Coutinho to who would have that connection that you can see Firmino and Coutinho have when they play together in real life. They're awesome. They link together so well, it's crazy. See what you can do when you play players together that know each other so well. I mean, you just have to look at the Manchester City game and to see how well Firmino and Coutinho can pick apart even in one of the best teams in the league. And in some style too. Here's Henderson. For that cross. Is it to Nathaniel Klein? That's a terrible cross from Nathaniel Klein. There's confirmation of the board's sale of Daniel Sturridge. So 48.5 million they only got for him. I was getting offered more than that from Newcastle. I almost wish I accepted Newcastle's offer when I got it. If I'd known, that would be all I'd get for him. At least I would have gotten 50 million from Newcastle. Correa, Neymar, 4 goals in 2 games. I didn't have to give that goal to Neymar, but this is the first goal you're going to see him score because you missed the hat trick. I could have given that to Correa, but nah, it had to be Neymar. First goal. Well, at Anfield as well. Right in front of the cup and easy goal. Well, nice way to get him off the mark at Anfield. Well, simple as that, really. Hey, not much more need be say. Aid. Was Brummer finding out exactly why they didn't want to play the informed team in the league? That's just asking for trouble. And Neymar scored again. Across from Elne. And Mom meets it with the head, and he's gotten them back to back now. Oh, he's on another hat trick. He's gonna have 6 goals from the first 2 games if he keeps this up. He's gonna be on that top goal scorers list before anyone else. He has more goals in 2 games than Jordan Henderson does all season. Henderson now has 4. He scored in the game against Leicester as well. As did Correa. So there you go, that's the five goal scorers oh, his name, I'm going to complete his hat-trick before half-time! Oof. It's still there. Oh, what skill from Coutinho! Oh, on the block! Foster, or he might have gotten lucky there. He may have gotten a tad lucky. My players are thirsty for goals. Chelsea are losing. Yo, Chelsea, if you just surrender her, it'd be just easier. Or you're just embarrassing yourselves. Well, no wonder Jose Mourinho got sacked. Acting in real life. He might get sacked in the game as well with the way Chelsea are going. The gap is going to be 24 points. The gap is actually going to be 24 points. This is mad. This title race is going to be probably the most one-sided title race in history. It doesn't help that I'm scoring constantly and I've only conceded two goals all season, and that every team around me is constantly dropping points. There's no one to challenge me. It's like how we thought City were going to be this season, but I don't know. Or where it was much closer than everyone thought it would be. Morrison, you want to be careful, man. And he could have easily, if he had fouled Neymar, Harry was very close to him. Be careful, he doesn't foul. What do you want? Goodness. Because that will be his game over. Yeah, Neymar went for the spectacular. We're trying to complete the hat-trick in style. Oh, wow. Oh, even after being tripped up, he still almost scored. The Brazilians, have they got like some sort of magic in their feet? I know we joked that Brazilians are like magicians on the ball, but do they have some sort of power over the ball? Do they really have some sort of power over the ball? Because that would explain a lot. That would explain why they have five world championships. Could be offside and he's flagged offside. I'm pretty sure Royce missed, even if he was offside. Or was it Correa who was offside? No, it was Correa who was offside. Correa was onside. He was where the yellow was. Because maybe it's saying he came back from an offside position. But it's where you are when the ball is played. Not where you were. If you came back from. If you were in an offside position when the ball was played. Then it's offside. Neymar, he wants the hat trick. Freaking Megan Jillian Lescott, no, will get it. Vrain, surely. How? Oh, lucky can one team get? Yes, Correa, Bale. Bale goes for a goal and is it denied by Ben Foster? Oh, a fantastic save, to be honest. You have to do something to prevent the goal. And a relatively weak header from Philippe Coutinho ends that little attack. And I don't know what I was trying to do there. Over my back is Ricardo Rodriguez. Darren Fletcher tried to take it off, maybe has only ended up conceding the throw. Here is Ricardo Rodriguez again. Gives it to Neymar. The hat trick is complete. 6 goals in 2 games. The Brazilian. He came here to score. He's like, he I know I was late to the party, hey, but I'm getting on that top scoreboard, boys. And suddenly, you forget that anyone's even missing. It's like, oh, whoa, lost Daniel Sturridge, but Neymar scoring hat-tricks for fun. It's 2 hat-tricks in 2 games. And no way he's going to keep that up, but fun times, yay! Coutinho, how does he still have the ball? Oh, I was going to say, hey, how did the West Brom not get it from him there with that tackle? Well, Olsen did get the ball from Coutinho. Let's try that again. And this time without losing the ball, Correa, he might get his name on the score sheet. He's not going to let the Brazilians have all the fun. And he's like, remember Argentina? We actually got to the final in the World Cup in Brazil. Somebody didn't. Ironically, because Neymar got injured. But there you go. Oh, slots it at home. He gets, I think that's his 13th goal. That might be 14th. I should have waited and see. I guess I can look after this match is over. I have an upcoming game against Southampton in the Capital One Cup. First leg of the semi-final. Henderson! Oof! No one seemed interested in defending that shot. It easily gone in. Oh, someone did defend it. I guess Morrison got a block on it. Neymar! Freaking hell. Calm down, Neymar. Oh, you've only been... You've been here a little over a week, and he's over... He's on 6 goals, and he's like, I want more! Oh. Or maybe he's saying he wants 4. Well, it's not going to matter whether he wants more or 4. You'll have to wait. He got another hat-trick. It's another win. It's... If Chelsea have dropped more points, it's just more domination. And it's just a step closer to the league title. And Chelsea have. They've lost to Watford. Watford, who are high-flying in this career mode. But Chelsea have lost another game. Cray, you played alongside Daniel Sturridge. What are you talking about? You taking his spot. Are you on some sort of drugs that I should be aware of, Cray? Because the EF. A will be pissed if you are. Let's see confirmation of that. That loss should mean Arsenal will go up into second, because they dropped points as well. Brilliant. Yeah, look at that. 24 points clear of Chelsea. 26 ahead of Arsenal. And now Watford are in fourth, having jumped above Manchester United. But United do have that game in hand, and against Spurs. It's not an easy game for the Reds. Red Devils, if they are looking to get back into the top four, they'd go behind Arsenal with just 1 point. It's not just about who's going to get the rest of the top four places, really. No one's going to catch me. That's ludicrous. It's the thing that anyone could. Hopefully Joe and I should go up. Did he go up? I didn't, you dick! My goalkeeper's gonna go up in the next training session, hopefully. In fact, they should all go up in the next training session, which is fantastic. Is this someone asking to play? No, it's a transfer offer for Luis Alberto. I don't really like this Alberto. He's not really made me want to play him. Anytime I've played him, he's really bad. Can you match his value, Spurs? Just, yeah, extra $500,000. I don't need it. It's nice that he'd be somewhat of some use. Wait, who was that? Oh yeah, I forgot. I had accepted an offer for Firmino from Valencia. Finally, he's gone. I've not problem with Firmino in real life. He's, except for the game against Newcastle, he plays almost every game fantastically, especially when he's paired with Coutinho. Like I stated, that they, on the day, they can tear just about any team apart. But in this game, I just can't seem to get him into the team. He missed. She went, Coutinho is my top goal scorer this season. And so, yeah, there's that. I'm going to play Otazel and Donsa in this game. And Ojo is going to play because he didn't play in the FA Cup in the last game. Other than that, yeah, that is the team I'm going to put out against Southampton in the first leg, and it will be changed up for the second. Wait, the FA Cup game is before that, isn't it? Yeah, it is. So I can play three different teams, give everyone some sort of chance. It's Shrewsbury. He in the next round of the of the FA Cup. Right. Interesting. Let's do this. Donsa, Ojo. I took Ojo out of the training session only to make sure my keeper got up. Ojo will go back in eventually. I kind of wish there was 6 training sessions so I could have Ojo and the keeper in there. You can't always get what you would like. It'd help if Ibn Kamano grew faster. Seriously. Things a good way to increase, speed up growth, and maybe even surpass the growth of of a play. Yeah, but come on, they play in almost every single cup game. Granted, Ibe isn't playing in this one, but Kamano is. He's chilling over there. They're waiting for me to pass him the ball. Oh, here's Divock Origi, who should be our main striker in real life, and at least until the January transfer window. Hint, hint, nudge, nudge, Jurgen Klopp. Seriously, he's practically a top goal scorer in the last couple of games. He hat-trick against Southampton in real life. Oof. In this actual fixture, when we play him in the quarterfinals. You know, you remember that? Southampton damn sure do. They haven't been the same since. Go on, Ings. Go on, Ings. Boom, Danny. Ings. Ings opens up the scoring. His second goal in the Capital One Cup. Not prolific in this competition, are you, Danny? You got a hat-trick in the game against MK Dons. So led us to victory. Get up, boy, I'm hurt. Riggy! Oof. Keep that end on sight. He just blatantly ignored me. I may as well be talking to the wall. Well, ladies and gentlemen. Come on, Ings. The pass didn't go as planned. But what is that? Or has it? Lash it? Oof. An ice for... Or was that Fonte? He who got in the way. He for... Southampton there. Pella, Classy, Bertrand, good pass back to Classy, he got cut out, they won it back though, cheeky buggers, won it off Ward-Prowse, no, it's try, he's Southampton, in. But the counter attack is on, Origi, he belted it, how did you miss? Like, only a few inches is left, and you would have scored. Pella. Oh, shit. Good block by Thiago Alloria. To prevent any danger of an equaliser. I'd love to get a nice big win so I can sim the second leg. That won't happen if, especially not if there's an equaliser, and he should have belted that one away instead of passing it out, and there is an equaliser. Fuck. Graziano Pella. Like the only team he hasn't scored against in real life. And here we are. He has scored against us now. Fucker. Come on. Let's ignore that goal. Oh, it's a home goal. It's not like this is Anfield. Hold. Hold. That would be. We're still in the driver's seat. He thoroughly. Here we have the away goal. Oh, and we're still going to win this match. Match comfortably. Donza. Ojo. What's the score here, boys? He's Ings. Ings going up against Wanyama. It's not exactly a good battle. Oh, I don't like Ings' chances. This is why I am as a very He tough played at beating. In a 1-on-1 situation, Ings, come on. Ojo, get another chance to whip it in. Thiago Lloris! He's got a few goals already this season. And in the Champions League. The captain of the second team is Thiago Lloris. He looking to make an impact in the cup. Ooh. Ojo's ambitious volley, let's put it like that, is easily met by the goalkeeper. Origi! Hey! Ojo for the chance! Oh no! Frosta, you dick! A goal there probably would have gotten him a loan, an offer. Although I have gotten one offer for him from Manchester City, but I'm not playing that game again. And if he didn't play at Middlesbrough, what does City think I'm smoking? City must think I'm really fucking stupid if they thought I'd go for that loan. I'm only going to loan him out to a team that was going to play him. And I know City won't. No fucking way. They have better players than Middlesbrough, and Middlesbrough didn't play him. Foul. I'll take the free kick. Easy way to get the ball into the box. Ojo! Oof. Who do I have on the bench that can make an impact? I think I've given each of those guys a fair amount of chances. I'm gonna bring on Tielemans, Emre Can, and Jordan Ibe. I'm going for a juggler here. And here comes those substitutions. Gafira, it's time the goal will work. Chan is the first of the subs to make contact with the ball. And Origi, he might get a goal. Oh no, he's giving it to Ings! Easy tap! And then Danny Ings was his second of the game. I don't think the simulating the second leg is going to be an option unless I can get two, maybe three more goals. Come on, Jordan. See your ability. Jordan Ibe? He has the ability! Ooh, Fraser Foster is a luck. You lucky man. As you can see, the money I spent on Neymar has been very well reinvested by Barcelona. They've gone out and signed Matic for whatever reason. And they've been linked with Robben. Yeah. Barcelona are like, oh, we lost Neymar. Oh, it's okay, we can just get Robben. And you just have to go like, fucking what? Oh well. Southampton are gonna look for that that equaliser. John Ibe! Ooh! Looking for it in the form of Sadio Mane. Ibe. Ooh, that was gonna be an own goal. Probably would have been an own goal. Where had it gone in? And that was off the boot of a Southampton player. I'm not sure how it didn't go down as a back pass. Yes. Alright, Chan. And. Yo, I scored! Let me have the goal! Oh. Oh, really? Ah, fuck you. Oh. See who's got good free kicks. Tillemans. Southampton are like, yo, get someone on the pitch. They bring on Rumu, who former Chelsea player, bring off Victor Wayama. I would have left Wayama on, to be honest. And they didn't put Tillemans on the free kick. Go on, Tillemans. Don't know what I was expecting. Riggy. The man's Ings, who was looking for a hat trick. Oof! Just unlucky not to get it. It's going out for a throw. Oh, get it, Kamala. Oh, maybe we can snatch a third goal late in this game. We'll have a nice 2-goal advantage to take into the home leg. Ings. Tillemans. Alberto Moreno is offside. It was Tillemans who was offside, but Moreno's goal will not count. He just can't get any luck against Southampton, can he? His goal against them in real life was taken by Origi. This one was ruled out for offside for a different player completely. Just no luck against the Saints for this Spanish left back. Might still get a third goal if Camano can get there. He won't. He was never gonna get there. Oh, but this might lead to number 3. No, Cedric has done very well there to deny it. I think you can blow the whistle, ref. Yeah. Fraser Foster. Wouldn't be surprised if he got man of the match, even though I won 2-1. Would not be surprised in the least. Riggy. Wait, maybe there's still a chance. And it's come to Ibe. Oh wait, it's a penalty! He's in the penalty against Bertrand. And it's a red card! Wait, what did he do? Well, Ryan Bertrand won't be. Yeah, playing in the FA Cup. Not because suspension's over, but he will play against us in the. Oh, I thought he just nudged him. Now he slid in. This is Danny Ings' chance to complete his hat trick. Yeah, sorry. I think it's Kamano. Yeah, it's Kamano who's being put up to take it. Sorry, Kamano, but Ings is on a hat trick. I have to, in good faith, give it to Danny. He, for the hat trick, for the chance. Oh, Foster saved it! What a dick! The drama is real here at the end of this game. Him. Kamano. Romero, no. Oh, thank Christ he blew the whistle. Imagine if they'd gone down and then scored a fucking equalizer. I would have been pissed. This, in the end, it's 2-1. And I beat 10 men Southampton 2-1. I missed a penalty. They had a player sent off for the penalty. It was utter freaking chaos. That's there at the end. And Foster has to be given a lot of credit for saving that shot. I've gotten another offer for Ojo. Spurs are not willing to play. Yeah, that's... I can... That extra half million. Who is it? It's Ipswich. Oh, Mick McCarthy. Yeah, Ipswich would play him. Thanks, Mick. Maybe Roy Keane was wrong about you. I don't like him either, to be honest. So yeah, there you go. Ojo has gone. Now he'll spend 2 seasons on loan at Ipswich. Which hopefully he developing into quite a good talent. And maybe he'll get him promoted, who knows. But that is the end of this episode. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. Like, comment, and subscribe if you did. And until next time, I will see you all soon.